Welcome to Open Heaven's Devotional Commentary, a guide to a close fellowship with God with Salami Eneojo Haruna, your host. We are glad to have you today.
Hello, good morning. Thank you for joining us today again. Open Heavens is written by our Father and the Lord, Pastor E.A. Adeboye, General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God. And this commentary is intended to bring insights to God's Word by the help of the Holy Spirit. Today's date is Tuesday, the 8th day of June 2021, and our topic for today is Prayers for Elders. Before we go into the prayers for our elders, let us pray. Our Father in Heaven, we bless your name. Thank you for the grace to intercede. Thank you for your promise to us that you would always hear us when we call. We ask that your ears would be inclined to our prayers today in the name of Jesus. Let us see speedy manifestations of our requests to your glory. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Amen. Praise God. In our memory verse today, we read from the book of Acts chapter 14 verse 23. Acts 14:23 reads, "And when they had ordained them elders in every church and had prayed with fasting, they commended them to the Lord on whom they believed." Acts 14 verse 23. And our scripture reading for today is from the book of Joel chapter 2 verse 25 to 28. Joel 2 verse 25 to 28 reads, "And I will restore to you the years that the locust had eaten, the cankerworm and the caterpillar, and the palmer worm, my great army which I sent among you. And they shall eat in plenty and be satisfied, and praise the name of the Lord your God that had dealt wondrously with you, and my people shall never be ashamed. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else, and my people shall never be ashamed. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions." God bless his word in Jesus' name. Amen. So today we'll be taking our time to pray for our elders. Those who have gone before us would be lifting them before the Lord and be trusting God that he would perfect all that concerns them. Let us just open our mouths and bless the name of the Lord, thank him for all of our elders. We thank you, Jesus, for the gift of elders. Thank you for your covenant of long life that we have elders amongst us. We bless your name in Jesus' name. Ask the Lord and say, "Please, Lord, help them to stay true to their calling as men and women of wisdom. In the name of Jesus, they will be known for the wisdom you've given them. Let their length of years be crowned with divine wisdom and understanding. Let there be great and powerful insight into things in the name of Jesus. Let they have wisdom that cannot be gainsaid." Ask the Lord and say, "Father, please help all our elders to finish well. None of them will lose their place in your kingdom in the name of Jesus. Father, grant unto them the finisher's anointing, the grace to finish well and strong. None of them would be robbed of their blessings in the name of Jesus. They will not stop halfway. They will not get tired. They will not be weary. In the name of Jesus." Ask God and say, "Father, please heal all our elders who may be sick in their bodies. Touch them and take away the sickness and all its symptoms in Jesus' name." Scripture says that healing is the children's bread. Because of his stripes, we are healed. Let every form of illness in their bodies, be it as a result of old age or whatever, we declare that they live now in the name of Jesus. Let their strength be renewed as of the days of their youth in the name of Jesus. Ask the Lord and say, "Father, let none of the elders suffer the sickness and diseases that plague people in their old age. Father, give them divine health in the name of Jesus. These ones are preserved." Ask and say, "Lord, as you used Moses until age 120 years, please continue to use all our elders for your glory in the name of Jesus. They would never expire in your scheme of things. We ask that, Lord, you would use them. Let them be mighty tools in your hands. Let they arise and take their place in your end-time army. Let they do greater works than they have ever done before in the name of Jesus. They will never be tired. Their fire for you will never go down in Jesus' name." Ask the Lord and say, "Father, for those of our elders who have stopped dreaming, it is not over until you say so, Lord. Our elders will dream again in Jesus' name. Open their eyes, open their minds. Cause their eyes to see in the name of Jesus. Let there be elders indeed. Let their eyes receive sight again. Your word says our old men will dream dreams. Father, these ones would not miss out on your promise in the name of Jesus." Ask the Lord one more time and say, Father, protect our elders in all their ways. Let the blood of Jesus speak for them every day. Let no harm come near them or their dwelling in Jesus' name. Father, we ask that your eyes of protection, your angels would camp around them in the name of Jesus. We refuse to receive evil news about them in Jesus' name. They are going out and their coming in is safe. Every evil eye seeing them as soft targets today are blinded in Jesus' name. Amen. Ask the Lord and say, Father, if there are lands and territories our elders have not covered according to your will for them, please help them to arise with strength to take over these territories so their assignments are completed in Jesus' name. Father, we ask today that you give them the grace to die empty. All their assignments you've given them, they will fulfill in the name of Jesus. The grace, the wisdom, the enablement, the divine leading and orchestrations that they need to take over lands and territories to your glory, Lord, grant unto them in the name of Jesus. Lord, we commit our elders before you. Your word says that I have been young, now I'm old. I've never seen the righteous forsaken nor his seed beg for bread. Lord, we stand upon your word and we agree that our elders would never be put to shame. They would not lack. The heavens are opened over them. Their needs are met even before they come in the name of Jesus. We pray for as many who are trusting you for one open door or the other. Those doors are opened in the name of Jesus. They will be so blessed they will lend to nations in Jesus' name. Pray and say, Father, we decree that our elders are blessed with long life and good health. They will see their grandchildren and great-grandchildren, even to the fourth generation in Jesus' name. Lord, your word has promised to satisfy us with long life and show us your salvation. We ask that in the name of Jesus, our elders receive long life and good health. None of them would be cut short. 70 and 80 would be the minimum that any of them would reach in the name of Jesus. We agree today that in the name of Jesus, they will see their grandchildren, they will see their great-grandchildren, even to the fourth generation. Our elders will abide with us and would never be snatched away before their time. In the name of Jesus, would pray and say, Lord, no matter what happens, our elders will live fulfilled lives in Jesus' name. They will see all their dreams come true in Jesus' name. They will laugh for joy in the mighty name of Jesus. Ask the Lord and say that they will be satisfied in the name of Jesus. They will never know any form of shame. They will glory in the God of their salvation. We declare that their table is set in the presence of their enemies. Those intended to mock will bow their heads in shame to your glory. And in the end, our elders will receive victory and would laugh for joy in Jesus' mighty name. Now it is time for our own personal prayer points for our elders. Those around you, call them by name. In the name of Jesus, we declare that you would see the faithfulness of our God. You will eat the good of the land. Whatever you set your hands upon is blessed. Your children would love you and honor you. You'd be a solution to the world. You'd be sought after. Whatever was a reproach in your life before now is now turned into a mega testimony in the name of Jesus. Your children will make you proud. And you'd see of a truth, the Lord has been faithful. In Jesus' name we have prayed. Everlasting Father, we are grateful. Thank you for helping us to stand in the gap for our elders. We thank you for the great news and testimonies that would follow. We ask, O God, that we would all live to be elders and enjoy the manifestation of these same prayers we have prayed today in our own lives in the name of Jesus. We thank you and we bless your name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. We have our thanksgiving today and would say thank you, Father, for all your elders who you have faithfully kept to their old age. Just appreciate the name of the Lord. Say, Father, we thank you for keeping them in good health and sound mind. Thank you for protecting them despite all that is happening in the world today. We bless your name, Jesus. We ask that your blessings will be so numerous they cannot count them all in Jesus' name. Amen. In our Bible in 1 year reading plan for today, we read from the book of 1 Samuel chapter 8 down to chapter 11. Praise God. Thank you for joining us today. We are glad that you are here again. Thank you for making our time to pray. If you love to speak to someone or to receive updates like this daily, please send a WhatsApp or Telegram message to +234 80 986 11226. Bless someone today and let this prayer continue as you share with them. Receive the grace to live long, fulfilling and satisfied lives also today in Jesus' name. Amen. Bye for now and have a great day.
I believe you enjoyed today's devotional. We'd love to hear from you. kindly leave a comment. You can connect with us on any of our social media handles attached. God bless you. Have a great day and see you tomorrow.